Hello guys, here I am with another iOS 16 video. In this video, I will show you how to downgrade iOS 16 beta back to iOS 15 without losing data. This is the latest video about iOS 16 downgrade, where iOS 16 beta 3 will be downgraded back to iOS 15.6.1. As you can see, my device iPhone XS Max is running iOS 16 beta 3. As I mentioned, we will downgrade back to iOS 15 without losing data. Before you do anything else, you first need to take complete backup of your device running on iOS 16. You can take the backup either on the iCloud or on your computer as well. To take the backup, open the iTunes, select the preferred option, and click on the Backup Now button. Depending on the data you have in your device, it will take a little while. As you can see, the backup is now completed. Now we will start to downgrade iOS 16 back to iOS 15 without losing data process. I will use the UltFone iOS system repair tool for the downgrade purpose. Here is the official product page of the UltFone iOS system repair. As you can see, it can do numerous things. It got both paid and free features. You can enter and exit the recovery mode with just one click. Moreover, it can fix 150 plus iOS system related issues. The option we will use is downgrade from iOS 16 beta without the iTunes. The UltFone iOS system repair is available for both Mac and Windows. Whichever computer you have, you can download it. Apart from this, these are the numerous things it can do for you. I already have installed this on my computer and activated. You can download it from the link given below in this video's description. Download and install it and start the process to downgrade iOS 16 to iOS 15 without losing data. Here is a simple, easy to use interface of the UltFone iOS system repair. Connect your device first with the computer and click on the start button. You will find two options here, standard repair and deep repair. We will use the deep repair for downgrading iOS 16 to iOS 15. Select the deep repair option and click on the deep repair button. Here on the next screen, it will ask you to download the latest available iOS firmware for your device. I personally recommend that you use this tool to download the iOS firmware on your device. Just click on the download button and it will start downloading the iOS firmware on your computer. Depending on your internet speed, it could take long or a short time. Once the download is completed, you will see this screen. Here, just click on the Start Deep Repair option. Before you do that, make sure you do not disconnect your device while the process is running. Also make sure if you are running this process on a laptop, keep your laptop connected to the charging. Here on this pop-up, you can read that Deep Repair will erase all your data. This is why I took the complete backup of my device before running this downgrade process. If you haven't backup your device yet, click on the cancel button, go back in this video and follow the steps to take complete backup of your device. We will restore that backup back into the iOS 15.6.1 later in this video. Once the backup is taken, click on the repair button. The process will start to downgrade iOS 16 back to iOS 15. Now sit back and wait for the downgrade process to complete. First, it will verify the firmware. After that, it will start downgrading. Hello guys, if you have made this far in this video and you are enjoying this video, hit the like button. This way YouTube will push my video to the other people as well. Also hit the subscribe button for more iOS related videos. Now it's going through the iOS 16 downgrade process. This will take a long time. I will put little cuts in this video so I can keep it short for you. As you can see, it's stating deep repair completed. The process to downgrade iOS 16 back to iOS 15 is completed. Once it completes, if your device does not restart properly, restart your device manually. As the downgrade part is completed, now I will show you how you can restore the backup taken of iOS 16 back to iOS 15. This does not work normally. We need to make some changes. Follow me in this video. Now press Windows and R button on your computer. you will see this little pop-up, and here type percentage sign add data percentage sign again and click on the OK. Once this folder opens up, go into the Apple computer, then in the mobile sync. Here you will find the backups taken using the iTunes. You might be wondering, currently it's not showing any backup on the screen. Due to low C drive space issues, I have changed the iTunes backup location to another drive. Now once I take a backup, it automatically transfers the backup to the other drive. If you also got the storage problem, leave a comment below in the description if you want me to make a separate video on changing iTunes backup location. I will make that for you. Once you are in the backup location, open the backup folder. Here is my iTunes backup folder in another drive. Open the backup folder, scroll down at the bottom, right click on the info.plist file, then open it with the notepad. We need to make some changes in this file. Once the info.plist file is open, press Ctrl plus F. We need to find something, type product in this and hit enter. Once it finds the product, scroll down a little until you find the product version. As you can see, it's currently stating 16 here as a product version. Change this 16 to 15 and save the file. This has to be changed back to 15 to restore backup taken on iOS 16 on the iOS 15. Once the file is saved, close it and open the iTunes. As you can see, currently the device is completely empty. So here on this screen on the iTunes, select the first option, Setup as New iPhone. Select the option and click on the Continue button. Click on the Get Started. As you can see guys, the iOS version is currently being shown is iOS 15.6.1. Let me just show you on my device as well. The device is successfully downgraded from iOS 16 public beta back to iOS 15. Now the last part is just to restore the backup. To restore the backup, first select the preferred option where you saved the backup. In my case, I saved it on my computer. I will select this computer option. After that, click on the restore backup option. For the backup to restore, you must turn off Find My on your iPhone. If you don't know how you do that, you can see that on your screen right now. I am doing it. It will ask you to put in the password to verify. As you can see, the Find My iPhone is turned off. Now we can restore the backup. Click OK. Then again, click on the restore backup. If you have multiple backups, you will see complete list here. Select the one where you change the product version. After the preferred backup is selected, click on the restore. Depending on the backup size, this will take a long or a short time. Mine backup file is big, so I will just close the video here. Once it completes, you will have all the data back in your device. This is how to downgrade iOS 16 back to iOS 15 without losing data using the UltFone iOS system repair tool. If you have any question, leave a comment below guys. Also hit the subscribe button for more iOS related videos. Thank you for watching.